Good morning. Good morning. Good morning to the world out there. This is a good day being here with the man boy. Let's give God some praise there. Now, as you noticed, the topic right here, why? And God, let them hurt Jesus. Who's them? That's the Jewish people. You know, this happens during Roman times. So, all can read the book of Ephesians chapter 1, verses 7 through 10. Right. And in 1 Sam, it said, God's goal was to finish his plan when the right time came. He planned that all things in heaven and on earth be joined together with Christ as the head. Next. Now, what does it mean? It means that God did not keep his plan secret. It was also a difficult thing for the world to understand God's plan. But God's plan was to send Jesus Christ to unite Jews and Gentiles in one body. The same today. You know, ever since, God does not like division in the church. No. He wants us all together. Watch here in his death ministry. Notice that we have hearing and deaf, Hispanic, white, black, Indian, different forms of writing, all different kinds become one body of Christ. Women to men, you know, the other sins become one Christ family principle. And it's really pleasing to God. Now, this is very important that we will all learn about. That way the world knows, first of all, who is God? It's amazing how people do not believe that God knows it. But for me, telling you, I'm going to tell you this about who is God. God is our creator. In Genesis chapter 1, verse 28, you can find it in the book. In the world, you can read this. Now, it says God is our heavenly Father. See, God is our Lord. He rules and protects his creation. In Psalms chapter 36, verse 6, he made and protected us. Number two, he deserves our highest honor. In the book of chapter 10, verse 9 through 15. Should. Next. Think. God knows all our weaknesses. Thought. And word. Can you imagine? Even a president who ran to become president of the United States of America. Everything. He knows everything. God knows. He knows what will happen. Very interesting. God can do anything and everything. Now, God also knows our actions and our needs. He already knows about it. Gee, God is so great that he is everywhere at the same time. What is inside of you? God told you. Hey, God is more powerful than anything else. God. Can we find the truth in there? This is going to keep on going right here. God loves us so much that he sent his son, Jesus, to earth to save us from sin. Hey, God promised us that if we believe in Jesus, our soul will live forever with him. Now, to apply this, you can know God by having is Jesus. Now, Jesus is the Son of God, of course. Jesus is the light of the world. When Jesus died, he took all of our sin with him. When he did, when he came back alive, he proved that he is the Son of God. Next. Jesus promised to come back someday. Don't know when. The Father only knows when. If we believe in what Jesus did, God will forgive us all the bad things we did. Everyone who believes in him will have a place in heaven. There. See, do you know that God is saving many rooms up in his heaven? So, it is very important that we all keep our faith. Keep on holding forever as long as we live here. Don't let go. Do not. Never. And don't just hold on. God and the world. Think, oh, I love God and I love the world. No, can't do that. If you're stubborn and holding on, then that means you got to be careful. You're going to let go. Next. Now, who is the Helper? Or the Holy Spirit? So he's the president. A, he is the Helper, Comforter, Giver, and himself is God. So upon this, in the book of Matthew chapter 18, verse 19 to 20, it says the Holy Spirit is God at work in believers. The same way in the book of John chapter 4, verses 23 to 24, the Holy Spirit helps us to worship God. Means that we all, brother, sister, let him, God, Jesus, the Holy Spirit, three in one, let us go. And that we need to be controlled as well. Now, here's another question for you, the final question. Why did God let the Jewish people hurt Jesus? When Jesus was being hurt, he could have called on 10,000 angels to come and save him. But guess what? Jesus did not. After all, himself was God's Son. Jesus chose to suffer and died for us. Even Jesus loved us so much that he did what it took to pay our sin. Jesus accepted everything. You do not have to die. I will die for you. And finally, Jesus and the Father agreed that it was necessary for him to die on the cross. Okay. So, before I close, what did we learn from today's lesson? Well, we know that who is God, who is Jesus, and who is the Holy Spirit. And then we learned that why did God let them hurt Jesus? So I hope that you have learned just how much God loves us, the world, that died and then saved us from sin. So, those who are taking the Lord's Supper just recently finished. Great. But, if anyone that missed it, there's probably a reason. You can ask that you need to change your mind. Why? Because once you take the bread, the cup, we should be thanking God for willing to die on the cross for us. So, we should not hold that sin. We need to let go and become free from what? Any sin that we did, you know, before, recently, you know, maybe 1 week ago, 1 day ago, 1 hour ago, 1 year ago, you held on to that sin. Let it go. Thinking, oh, I'm going to hold on to that sin. I'm going to hold on to that sin. You need to let go of that. And you need to die and give your whole mind, heart, spirit, God. And in that way, God will let you live to understand. Let Him control in me. So, that way you would feel like a new person from now on and sin no more. Talk negative? No. Think negative? No. Act negative? No. It's important that we must move on and be positive all the time. Not easy, of course, but hey, if all your thoughts, problems, everything, including your life, He will make you have an easier and better life every day. Later on, get used by coming every first Sunday of the week, meetings every Sunday, take the Lord's Supper, and take. But the more that you need to pray and give thanks to God at all times. 24/7. Continue on. If you do it, you can. Don't let Satan have a little part of you and me. None. I want us all to have a good life. Enjoy your life. Enjoy your love and the fellowship and the brothers and sisters in Christ. If anyone is like, please, meet that brother or person. You know, meet them on 101 and say, hey, I'm sorry, but we have a problem. Let us stop it now. Do not hold that problem. Hold. You think God's going to create that? No way. So, anyone who wants to come forward for repentance or prayer, or be baptized, please come. Let us sing. Next. <Nick. coughs>